And we are live. Praise God. Hallelujah. Happy Mother's Day. Hey, 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 hey. When the Lord created women, of course, we know that he took created women from the rib of the man. But he said that, you know, man should not be alone, that he should have somebody that like looks like him, that's similar to him. And he created us to be helpmeets for men, but he said that truly that we're also equals. Amen? Praise God. The man is not better and greater than the woman, and the woman is not better and greater than the man. So we thank God for women. We thank God for mothers. And there are mothers who take many forms and many shapes. We had a member who used to say that, you know, you can mother someone without having brought them into the world biologically. Amen? So we thank God for mothers. And we thank God for grandmothers who are also playing that role of mothering to the children of their daughters. Amen? So we thank God for all of you. We thank you for joining us. And we thank God for our pastor, Reverend Larry T. Edwards. And we pray that everyone continues to have such a great and wonderful day. Okay? God bless you and God keep you. And stay safe.
Good morning. Good morning and welcome on this second Sunday, which we celebrate Mother's Day. And to all mothers, grandmothers, I want to say to you, Happy Mother's Day. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we come this morning with our heads bowed.
Yes, yes, yes.
We come this morning with thanksgiving upon our lips.
Yes, Lord. Thank
we come, Heavenly Father, realizing that you're God and you're God all by yourself. We thank you for this special day, not just Mother's Day, but your day, Lord.
Mm.
Father, we thank you for watching over us last night as we slumbered and slept.
Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah.
And then, oh Lord, early this morning, you touched our bodies with the finger of love and started us on another day. So, Lord, we just say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, bless mothers everywhere. Father, the world would be in a bad place without mothers.
Mm.
But you took this special group of women to lead the future to people, young boys, young girls, and even some older people. So, Father, thank you for the wisdom that you've given them. Thank you for the leadership.
Yes,
bless all mothers, dear Lord. And, Father, as we expound upon your word today, we ask that people will open their hearts and minds that they might be receptive to thee. In Jesus' name we do pray and ask these blessings.
Yes,
amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
This time we want to go to Luke 1. Luke 1, verses 26 through 30.
Amen.
Hold on, let me see. Who we got on the phone? Who do they have on the phone? I know Sister Elk. Sister Rosina, anybody else? Okay, go ahead.
Amen, amen. Again, that's the book of Luke. Amen, the gospel of Luke, the first chapter, the 26th through the 30th verse, and it reads, "Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, 'Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women.' But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, 'Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God.'" Amen.
Amen. My brothers and sisters, especially mothers, mothers, you are praised today in a special way. So I want you to be blessed on this day, this Mother's Day. This is for anyone that has had a hand in rearing a child. Lord, we thank you for good mothers. Amen? I will not hold you long this morning because I feel that there's something special planned for each of you. But as we take a look at Luke 1, we just read verses 26 through 30. Amen?
Amen.
Just a tad of history. I want to give you a tad of historical information. Mother's Day, a day organized by Anna Jarvis. Anna Jarvis in 1907, she invited some people to her home in Philadelphia to commemorate her mother's death and announce plans to make Mother's Day a national holiday. On May 10th, 1908, the first Mother's Day service was held, and 2 years later, Governor William Gasket of West Virginia officially pronounced the first Mother's Day. That's a little history for our banks. Amen?
Amen, amen.
Mothers, we thank God for each of you. We thank God for real mothers, whether biological, whether surrogate, or a special group of blessed women. I just want to say this morning, mothers, you are blessed. You are truly what we need in the world today. Focusing on it, our attention on Luke 1:28, which reads, "And the angel came in unto her, and it said, Hail, thou that art highly favored."
Yes, yes, yes.
Blessed are those women. Mothers, you are blessed among women.
Hallelujah.
And we thank God for thee. Amen?
Amen.
Blessed are thou among women. What a great remark the angel made to Mary. Thou art highly favored.
Highly favored.
Praise God. Announcing to her that she will be given divine favor. She's going to be the mother of the Savior.
Hallelujah.
Favor can be better than blessings. Amen. Mothers. And I'm catching my throat here. Mothers, be thankful that our God found favor with you and blessed you with a child. Next to salvation, the greatest gift that can be, that's the greatest gift that can be given.
Our gifts.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Today, same as when God spoke to Mary, the world is in chaos. Unrest among nations.
Yes.
Children are doing their own thing. Telling parents what time they gonna come in.
Hallelujah.
And dare the parents to lock the door.
Yes.
There's no family values anymore. Choices are being made that are outside of our biblical teaching. There's no self-respect or human decency. It seems that all is lost. But let me share something with you this morning. You know, there's still some gap standards. Amen? God has provided a special group of women, which he called mothers.
Yes,
are willing to take a stand.
Stand in the gap.
Real mothers, not buddy mothers.
Yes.
See, there's a difference between buddy mothers and real mothers. See, the buddy mother wants to hang out with the child or their child, amen, and call themselves being cool. Amen? But that's not what we mothers we're talking about. We're talking about real mothers. These are women who have traits like Hannah in 1 Samuel 1 through 2. Mothers who will stand in spite of difficulties.
Hallelujah.
Willing to take the path where it leads. High and low. Mothers will be there with their child.
Woo, my God.
In good times and in bad times.
Thank you, Lord.
Willing to take the path wherever it leads. High or low.
Yes.
Willing to go through hell for the good of their children.
Dealing high water.
Women who will face disencouragement. Who will make sure the family will succeed in spite of the situation. When the world is telling her it cannot be done, she knows how to fall on her knees. And ask God to let his will be done.
Turn them over to him.
She lives inside God's will.
My God.
And God will take her through.
Yes, he will.
God has given us mothers who can take a situation of desperation and make it one of hope through prayer.
Thank you, Lord.
Hannah was in a desperate situation. The Lord had caused her to be barren. But the sister prayed and a change was wrought.
Yes,
there are some mothers who are in dire situations.
God answers prayers.
But God has given them the answer. And that answer is just seek him. And he will make your life better. He will give you the guiding light.
Yes, he will.
To guide your children to higher heights.
Jesus is the light. Yes, Lord.
God's group of special mothers are here today. And we pray for mothers everywhere.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
We got to pray that they have the assurance if they give it all to God,
mm-hmm.
blessings will come through.
He's our hope.
They're not afraid to try.
Jesus, Jesus.
They push, that is, they pray until something happens.
Hallelujah.
And that something is God's will.
Yes, yes, yes.
Mothers, I charge you this morning to move forward.
Jesus, Jesus.
Be a part
Jesus.
Of the present system of things.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
But every once in a while, you have to go back to the principles. That's the old old foreparents taught.
Mm.
You got to teach them that it's okay to pray.
Mm.
It's okay to be honest.
Hallelujah.
It's okay not to lie.
Mm.
It's okay to work. It's okay to be decent.
Jesus.
And
Jesus.
Want to establish a relationship mm-hmm. with God.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Mothers are special.
My God.
I thank Jesus. God for my mother.
Mm.
My mother taught me. She taught us, my brothers and sisters, she taught us how to pray.
Mm-hmm.
She carried us to church.
Yes, yes.
She read us Bible stories.
Mm.
And she taught us to recite the scriptures.
Yes, yes.
What a better place this world would be in if these principles were taught in the home today.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
The best contribution, I'm sorry, the best contribution a woman can make to the world is a godly child.
Oh, yes.
The best gift a child can have is a godly mother.
Hallelujah.
If you are a mother this morning, you're blessed among a special group of women.
Mm-hmm.
You've had the opportunity to assist in helping not only your child, but other children in becoming connected with Jesus Christ.
Yes, be an inspiration.
Mothers, you are blessed. You're a blessed group of women.
Yes, yes.
But most of all, you're chosen by God.
Mm.
Use this blessings to share with all that you come in contact with. I want you to tell them about Jesus.
Tell them about Jesus.
Tell them about his love. Tell them how
God.
He died.
Hallelujah.
Was buried and rose so that we could have eternal life.
Unconditional love.
Mothers, I challenge each of you
Jesus,
to
Jesus.
Reach out to some mother this week
mm-hmm.
and invite them and their child to our children to or worship with you on whatever Sunday you go to church.
Amen, amen.
Lord, we thank you for mothers.
Yes, Lord.
And I thank God that he gave his son Jesus.
Mm.
That we can tell the story.
Oh, yes.
So mothers,
oh,
I want you to tell the world as I get ready to close.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to tell the world that Jesus is the lily of the valley.
Yes, he is. Yes,
tell them
he
that he is the rose of Sharon.
Mm.
Tell him that he's the bright and the morning star.
Yes, yes, yes.
Ezekiel says he's the wheel in the middle of a wheel.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
God is our creator.
Mm.
He is our sustainer.
Yes, he is.
He is the first and the last.
Oh, yes.
He's Alpha and Omega.
Yes, yes.
He's the beginning and the end.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
he is
Lord.
The author and the finisher of our faith.
Mm.
He's all in all.
Oh, yes.
All
yes,
we
got
to
yes.
do is stay prayerful.
Yes.
Mothers,
yes.
I ask that you continue to lead your children. Give them that foundation,
mm-hmm.
that solid rock.
Hallelujah.
That you might be able to lead them to higher heights. Be a good mother. Not only a good mother, be a great mother.
Hallelujah.
Try to teach your child to be productive in this life today.
Mm-hmm.
Teach them to hold on to God's unchanging hand.
Stay close.
Teach them to tell the story.
Yes.
Pray
yes.
for them that despitefully use you.
Mm.
Pray for them that curse you, and God says, I'll fight your battles.
Oh, yes, yes.
But
yes.
you got to be able to put it all in God's hand. One day we're going to have to give up the ghost.
Oh, yes.
One day we're going to have to stick our swords in the golden sand. Well, we won't have to study war anymore.
Hallelujah.
That day comes when the lion and sheep
mm-hmm.
will be able to lie down in peace.
Hallelujah.
There'll be no more wars.
Mm.
Every day will be
Jesus,
happy.
Jesus, Jesus.
I don't know about you, mothers, but I'm looking for that day.
My God.
When Gabriel sounds the trumpet.
Mm.
When the dead in Christ shall rise.
Yes, yes.
On their way to the third heaven. I don't know about you, but I want to hear that voice from
Hallelujah,
Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
I want to hear his voice say, servant of God, job well done.
Hallelujah.
You ran the race. You
finish your course.
Now come on up a little higher. And I'll make you ruler.
Over many things.
Thank God for mothers. Mothers,
Jesus.
This is your day.
Mm.
I want you to enjoy.
Yes, yes.
Let your family do something for you today.
Mm-hmm.
Every mother deserves more than a pat on the back.
Mm.
Because they've been through thin and thick.
Yes, yes.
We know mothers give in better than daddies, don't we? Mothers are the ones that I remember my mom and them had a king bed when we were coming up, and we had, y'all know, them little bunk beds and so forth. But whenever you say that you were sick, mom would tell you to go get in their bed. Daddy would come from work and you land in the bed. Amen. Just saying, well, we call it the king bed. Because they had a king bed and we had those little mattresses. But when you were sick, seemed like you felt better when you got in mama's bed. Mm-hmm. Or you got in with mom and dad and went to sleep because you were scared to stay in the room. Mm. But they made you comfortable.
Mama makes it
better. Oh, when you fell and bruised your knee. All mother would have to do is blow on her and she says, it's going to be okay.
That's because God.
Amen. God is a godly. God gives us godly mothers.
Yes, yes.
Oh, she had enough sense to pray when we didn't have bread on the table. But they always made a way that we could have bread on the table.
Oh, yes.
I always say that we could take a black eyed peas, collard greens, and make a meal better than any meal you ever ate.
Gourmet meal.
But you will, you will surely fool. So I thank God for mothers.
Mm.
How they used to grow our food in the backyard.
Hallelujah.
Take it out and cook it.
Mm.
But it was very fresh.
Yes, yes.
So I thank God again for mothers.
Oh, yes.
And you, as I close this morning, remember this. If you have your mother, you call her today. If you don't have your mother, remember she's in glory.
Right, right.
Looking down at you.
Mm-hmm.
But remember, if you live right, if you pray right, you can see mother in the morning.
Yes, yes.
But until that time comes, let's ask God to hold us in the hollow of his hand. Yeah. Let's ask him continue to share his blessing. And we be so careful to give him the praises. In Jesus' name, we ask all of these
Jesus
blessings.
Name.
Amen.
Amen.
Sister Edwards, lead us in prayer.
Amen, amen, amen. Pastor, if I could share, one thing we always look to when we think about a mother is just like a virtuous wife, a virtuous mother. And Psalm 31 shares a few things with us. We'll just do the last part of that. It says that strength and honor are her clothing. She shall rejoice in time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is the law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done well, but you exceed them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands and let her own works praise her in the gates. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory. We thank you, Father God, for the creation of women, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for knowing that a man needed a helpmeet. And Father God, we thank you for allowing us as women, Father God, to be a part of your great creation. We thank you, Father God, for giving us wisdom, for giving us, Father God, knowledge, for allowing us, Father God, and giving us the wisdom surely to draw closer to you, to make you and allow you to be our Lord and our Savior. We thank you for women, and we praise them and lift them up, Father God, all over this nation. Father God, we pray for those mothers who've been separated from their children at the borders. We pray for those mothers, Father God, who are addicted, Father God, to some addiction, whether it be alcohol or drugs or whatever, Father God, that have separated their mind, Father God, in such a way that they don't understand the precious gift that you have given them in their children. We pray for them, Father God. We pray that help will come their way. We pray, Father God, that all of those who do not know you and the pardon of their sins, Father God, can have their eyes, their minds, their souls, Father God, open up to you to receive you as Lord and Savior. We just pray, Father God, for this nation. We pray for this world that love, Father God, will dispel hate. We pray, Father God, that we can all come together as a family, as your family. Oh, Father God, we love you. We praise you. We just exalt your holy name. I thank you, Father God, for my mother, a mother, Father God, who read the Bible daily, a mother, Father God, who taught us through action as well as words, the word love. I thank you, Father God, for the two sons you're blessing me with, and I just am so grateful for them, Father God, and I'm so blessed. And I thank you, Father God, for the great daughter-in-law that you blessed us with for our younger son, and we thank you for the great in-laws that you blessed us with who are also spiritual and loving people. Father God, we thank you for our relatives and our family and our friends, Father God. And we pray, Father God, for all of them that they, as we lift them up to you, that they will be blessed, Father God, that they will be protected, that they will be kept safe, Father God, that your angels will be dispatched to be around them, Father God, to fight their battles and protect them from all hurt, harm, and danger. We lift up our church and our church members, Father God, their family members. Oh, Father God, we pray that continued blessings and safe harbors provided for them, Father God. We pray, Father God, for the health of this nation. We pray for the health of everyone, Father God, within the sound of my voice. We pray healing for our bodies from the top of our heads to the soles of our feet. Go with us, be with us, guide us, and keep us, we pray, Father God. Keep this great man of God keeping and sharing your word, Father God. And Father God, bless mothers for this Mother's Day all over the nation and all over the world. We thank you for the opportunity to be of service to our children. We thank you for the gifts you've given us. Continually be with us, guide us, and keep us, Lord, we pray. And all of God's children said, amen.
Amen.
Amen and amen. The Lord be praised.
Amen. God bless you on this special day. And I was thinking what I used to say to St. John when I first came there. I always say, when the women leave the church, I'm gone. Amen. Because they're the ones who make up the church.
Mm.
They do all, well, you know, we got some men that'll work.
Yeah.
But mostly you find the women working.
Jesus surrounded himself
so
with women.
So we thank God. Amen.
Amen.
We are soldiers in the army.
We got to fight, although we have to die.
We got to hold.
We got to hold up the bloodstained banner.
Got to hold it up.
We got to hold it up until we die.
Oh, we are soldiers in the army. We got to fight, although we have to die. We got to hold.
We got to hold up the bloodstained banner.
Got to hold it up.
We got to hold it up until we die.
Well, my mother, she was a soldier.
Oh, yes.
She put her hands on the gospel plank.
Oh, yes.
But one day she got old. She couldn't fight anymore. She said, I'll stand there and fight on anyhow.
Oh, yes,
we are soldiers in the army.
We got to fight,
although we
have to die.
We got to hold. We got to hold up the bloodstained banner. We got to hold it up until we die. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
We are soldiers in the army of the Lord.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
And we got to hold it up until we die.
Hallelujah.
As I always say in my closing, you pray for me, and I'll pray for you.
Oh, yes.
That's the way Christians ought to do.
Always.
You be blessed this day. And again, to all mothers, have a blessed, a safe Mother's Day. And I'll see you next Sunday. God
Amen.
Bless you.
Amen. God bless you and God keep you and stay safe. And happy Mother's Day. All enjoy. Right.